Hi everyone, welcome back to our fantastic VE class.
Here's Kenny and
Elaine
on the stand for a brand new lesson.
If this is your first time watching this video, remember to check the first episode so that you can know who we are and what are we trying to do here.
In the previous lesson, we had a general insight into the whole branch of behavior economics. We've talked about the basic definition of BE, some intro of prospect theory, and do you remember the Starbucks case we talked about?
Yeah, the vanilla cream frappuccino was awesome.
That was actually not a point, but anyway, in today's lesson, we're going to talk about a specific theory in the behavior economics. Elaine, imagine this. You're right now holding 10% of Starbucks stocks.
Well, really? Does that mean I get to drink 10% of all vanilla cream frappuccino produced in the whole world? Oh, a sweet dream.
Didn't you just promise to go on a diet last night?
Forget it.
Okay, listen. Here is the question. If the value of the stocks appreciates right now, what would you do?
Well, sell them at once to gain money, of course.
Well, think more. If the stock price goes up, it indicates a tendency of a continued increase in a period of time in the near future, doesn't it?
I see. That's the tricky point. The future is unpredictable. I'm afraid that I will lose more if I do not sell them immediately. Well, wait. Is this connected to the theory we are going to talk about today?
Exactly. See, the absolute rational thinking in this situation is to wait for a longer time to sell the stocks because, as I mentioned, they may continuously appreciate in value. Well, similarly, when the stocks face depreciation in value, a rational AI would choose to sell immediately because it predicts that the stock will fall to a lower price.
However, people always act in an irrational way, just like me. We act the opposite as what you just said, right? We sell as soon as there is appreciation of the stocks and hold the stocks when there is depreciation. Because people just commonly believe that the stock may rise in value next time.
Well, such phenomenon actually has a name, disposition effect. The disposition effect is identified and named by Hirschhoffen and Mir Stedman in 1985. To briefly summarize, it relates to the tendency of investors to sell shares when prices increase while keeping a set when it has dropped in value. From this perspective, we can say that irrational people in the stock market are having a gambling game.
Talking about gambling, it is all about one simple principle, to take risks. In the stock case, a man holding his stocks when there is depreciation in value takes the risk of losing more money as the stock might drop more. This is defined as risk-seeking behavior, referring to people who has a preference for risk.
Correct. In the other case, when there is appreciation in stock value, the immediate selling of stocks is called risk-averse behavior, indicating people's attempt to best reduce the uncertainty. In this case, people are trying to avoid the risk of the stock dropping after a small rise in value.
That sounds cool. I never realized that there are two completely contrary behaviors behind this. I think I love gambling simply due to the way it brings me tension and excitement.
Well, only if you can prospect correctly when making decisions. And it's time to uncover the name of a theory we're introducing today, the prospect theory.
So, if the case of the stock market is applied, is prospect theory about the tendency of people making decisions about their investment?
Bingo! In a simple explanation, the prospect theory suggests that when there's potential gain or loss when making a decision, people tend to ignore the final outcome and fear the loss more.
Oh, this reminds me of what we have talked about last time, the loss aversion and the prospect theory. I still remember that losses fell by 2.25 times more than equivalent gains. This means that if an outcome has equivalent potential gain and loss, the part of loss will be magnified for 2.5 times more in human minds, making him less willing to make the decision.
Exactly. Thus, they tend to maintain their gains, regardless of how much gain, as long as possible. Inversely, they tend to avoid taking more risk when there is potential loss.
Yeah, that is why gambling, uncertainties are so attractive. You may possibly be a poor wanderer on the street or a millionaire in Switzerland just in one moment.
That was quite impressive for a gambler who never get to win one millionaire game.
There you have another round with me, you remember last time?
Okay, let's talk about this later. Well, thank you for watching this episode of Fantastic Cast about prospect theory. Remember to subscribe and leave your comments under the video.
Your words and your comments will be the best motivation for us.
See you next time!